Well, today I'm bringing you a video to show you how to fix the Chuwi hi10. Now this problem's been caused through an incorrect BIOS being flashed through Windows Device Manager, which, yes, as people contradict, like Phone Doctor and other repair shops that I've been to, have all said that Windows Update does not do BIOS updates. Yes, it does. And I can say that once and for all, yes, it does. Now, the problem with this was it'd flash a Windows update from Device Manager. If you scroll through the devices, you'd see a firmware update. If you clicked it, it'd say there was a updated firmware available. If you clicked that, then it'd carry on to do an update. Now, the problem is, it'd update, and then as soon as you shut the tablet down and restarted, it would start raising the BIOS and writing it with a teclast firmware, which is a totally incorrect firmware for a Chuwi tablet. Now, I'm on a Chuwi tablet that's a 5000 plus serial number, which is good for me because it means it can boot now Windows 10 and Android. So all I need to do is flash this chip, which is the one marked with a yellow dot. The yellow dot is marking pin 1. I'll zoom out a little so you can see the whole tablet. There's the battery. There's the motherboard. There's the input for charge, which I'm just trying to put a bit of charge in the battery before I do the flashing. And there's the chip that we're actually going to flash. This is a bit awkward because I'm trying to hold a small lamp just for lighting. But I'll show you now how to proceed with that. Here's the SPI flash programmer. This is something you'll need to order from eBay or AliExpress or wherever, but I'm a UK buyer. So I managed to find this with the clip as well that you'll need, which is this device, which actually clips to the BIOS chip. Now, I found both of these on eBay in the UK. If you go on the Chuwi forums, you should see a link to it, where I actually show you how to get it for only £7.99. with delivery for both of these. And then you'll need the voltage converter, which, because that runs at a higher voltage than the BIOS chip needs, you need the voltage converter, which is here, to reduce the voltage down to be suitable to use with this chip. Now, as you can see, that's a BIOS chip with the yellow dot on, like I showed you. Now you basically hook these up together, and I'll show you how to do that now. That's the SPI programmer, and what you do is you take the voltage regulator and you plug it into the first 4 holes. Once you've plugged it in there, you press click down, which will hold that in place. Then once you've done that, you take your clip that goes on the chip, and the other end, which you can see here, is marked 1, make sure 1 is down towards the arm. And I'll try to do this in as much detail so you can actually see. There you go, and then press that clip down to lock that in place. So now these are locked together. Once you've done that, then you need to take this end of the clip, and basically all you do is find your BIOS chip, which is there, mount the yellow dot for pin 1. Pin 1 on the cable is the red line, or it'll be marked with text, but it's not another red line, which comes out on this pin at this side. So just line that pin, as you can see, the red line to the pin on the right on the chip, and it should have slots so it just clicks into place and sits there. And that's all there is to hooking that up to the device to actually flash it. And again, just to show you the configuration. Is that way around. Now this should work really for any China tablet that runs on a windbound chip. But we'll soon find out. Right, as I was saying, once you're in the CH341 programmer, what you want to do first is click on detect the chip, which is this button here. Actually, before that, you're best off selecting, I don't know if you can read that there, 2526 SPI flash for type. Struggling with the focus a bit there, but and then on menu, as it says there, but it's menu, is windbound, and then name W25Q64FW. W25Q64FW. I'll just try and get that in focus for you so you can see that clearly. It's not working very well, but yeah, there we go. Right, so there we have CH341A programmer. Click on type first, put in 2526 SPI flash. This is specifically for Chuwi hi10, a lot of the teclast tablets, probably the Chuwi hi12s as well, Chuwi hi8s. Then click on menu or menu, windbound, and then under that name, W25Q64FW. Once you select all that, then actually click on detect, which you can see up there. Click detect. I don't know if it's focusing on that very well. Click the detect button. Now don't worry too much if it doesn't actually, if it says it can't detect your chip. I had this problem, but it didn't cause me any issues, I just ignored it. Once you get to that stage, you can click on the erase button and it should start erasing your chip. Now don't panic if it doesn't, it just probably means your clip or something isn't quite right, so just check all your settings, the way you plug things in. But it's normally down to the clip itself. Click erase, it should take a minute or two to erase the chip. Once you erase the chip, then click to file, then open, then find the BIOS folder you've downloaded. Now if you've got 5000 series, you can download the dual BIOS, which will allow you to boot Windows and Android by pressing the up down volume key on booting. If you're below that, then you'll have to stick to the Windows 10 at the moment because Chuwi don't support dual boot on the older devices. I don't really understand why, because it seems an easy fix to me, but they're just not doing it. So if you have a 5000 series, it's the ones marked with a serial number. I don't know if you better see it on here, but it's the ones marked with the serial number. No, you're not going to make that out. So I'll read it out to you. It's the serial number. It starts with G64G4216020. Now, as a rule, they're under. Just take a notice of the 421602 number, to be quite honest. If you go by that, then yes, it can be. You can just download the official Chuwi dual BIOS from Chuwi website. Just go on Chuwi forums and you'll find it on there. Now that's quite an easy way just to explain it to you. Anything below that, no, you can't update. Basically, the 02061. Is the second of the 16th, to be quite honest, meaning the second month of the 16th year. Anything below that, you can't really use the dual boot because Chuwi just just won't have it at all. I don't know why, but that's just the way they work. Now, once you do that, and you've erased the BIOS, once the BIOS is erased, then you open your BIOS folder, and you just need the BIOS bin file. I don't know if you can make it out on there. BIOS bin. Open that. You'll see it on the screen open up. It'll be FFFFFFF58A55FO. Once you've got that on your screen, then click on write at the top. Write to chip. It'll take a couple of minutes to write it to the chip. Once it's finished completing writing to the chip, just click on verify, which is the one on the right to the right. Click on verify. Once you click on verify, another couple of minutes, and it should verify that every bit matches what you've originally got on the programmer. Once you've done that, then basically just plug your Chuwi in to charge, leave it 10 minutes, try switch it on. It should come straight on. Normally it'll come on by itself, but yeah, as a rule, it'll switch on after 5-10 minutes really. You might have to give it an hour or two if it's had a really flat battery, being stuck a couple of months put away because of the BIOS problem. You might have stuck it in a wardrobe or something and forgot about it. But just give it time to charge, then boot it up, and it should boot fine. The first thing you probably see is an Android asking you to boot to Android. Just press volume up and it should boot to Windows. If you want to install Android, go on the Chuwi website and download the official Android for it. You'll see it in the forums. If you just click forums, Chuwi hi10, it'll be under firmware, and then under firmware you'll find the Windows Chuwi software for the device, and it's quite simple and straightforward to install that, so I'm not going to go into that now. So I hope that helps a lot of people. Enjoy.